Hi everyone and welcome to another episode of Why Jamaica. I'm Netta and today we're at the second city of Jamaica, Montego Bay or Mo Bay. Now this city is mostly known for the all-inclusive resorts and the luxury lifestyle, but guess what? Today I'm going to show you a list of places and activities that you can do in Montego Bay for less than 10 US. You heard it right. So stay tuned if you're interested to travel in Montego Bay, but on a budget, it's definitely the episode for you. So our first stop of the day is Tropical Bliss Beach. It's located right in the entrance of Montego Bay City and very close to the airport of Montego Bay. In this area, you can also enjoy great food of the restaurant that they have over here. They have live entertainment, music, and also water activities. So you can definitely spend a whole day over here, rent your chair and a cabana and just enjoy your day. The entrance is only 5 US or 700 Jamaican. And you can enjoy all of the facilities in the area. Of course, you would have to pay extra for water activities and stuff like that. But again, just the ambience of this place is beautiful. I definitely recommend you to visit Tropical Bliss in Montego Bay. This beach is very clean and welcomed. Our second stop of the day is at Dead End Beach in Montego Bay, located between the airport of Montego Bay and the hip street of Montego Bay. This is a really relaxing local beach, and if you're looking for the Jamaican experience, this is the place to chill. They don't have too many facilities over here, but they do have vendors selling fresh fruits and refreshment, and also a bar and a restaurant right in front of the beach. And of course, it's a public beach, so it's free. You can come here at any time, enjoy and relax watching the planes landing or departing from Jamaica. It's really a beautiful, amazing sight. Next on our list in things that you can do in Montego Bay under 10 US is the famous Doctor's Cave Beach. Now, this beach is perfect for families and children because the water here are most of the time pretty relaxed and calm, and also they are pretty shallow, and there is great amenities in the area. There is also a membership option if you're here for a long term, and you can definitely relax in luxury over here. You have all of the facilities that you would need, from Starbucks very close and also a bar and a restaurant. So the entrance for this beautiful beach, very luxurious style, is only 6 US or 750 Jamaica. It's really affordable, and I mean, I love it because honestly, you can come here on any budget and just travel and have a great day over here. Guess what? There is another free beach in Montego Bay. So this beach is located in the middle of the city of Montego Bay, right in front of the big KFC that everybody knows in Montego Bay. This is the Harmony Beach. It was developed recently and renovated by the Urban Development Corporation, the UDC. You can find yourself spending here easily an afternoon. They have a park area, a playground for kids, all the facilities of a restroom, changing room, and all of that as well. The only thing over here to park, you would have to pay a small fee, but the entrance is completely free. So feel free to come and enjoy this beautiful beach for a really chill and relaxed afternoon. All right, so we are at our next location, and this is Margaritaville in Montego Bay. This is one of probably the most famous locations on Jimmy Cliff Boulevard, the hip street. This is a beautiful place to stay and spend an afternoon with your family or friends. You can either dine over here at the restaurant, drink something at the bar, and guess what? Enjoy free water activities. So come over here and visit Margaritaville. It's a really beautiful area and just a chill spot to relax in the afternoon. Next on our list of things you can do in Montego Bay on a budget is the Yacht Club in Montego Bay, located in the Freeport area and close to a lot of hotels in the area. This place is really isolated and quiet. The beauty about this place is that you can enjoy a different ambiance. There are lots of yachts around you, and there is a whole private membership club over here where if you have a yacht, you can join, of course, but you can also just enjoy the view over here or either schedule a sailing if you're coming to visit Jamaica. When you enter, you can see they have a whole club house where you can learn about the history of the industry here in Jamaica. And then also, if you're interested and if you're here for a long time, there are also courses, sailing courses that they actually do here at the Yacht Club. It's a perfect place to come as a couple if you're looking for a place to you know, have some romantic time and a date, or if you're looking for a quiet place to do a business meeting, great location as well. This yacht club also has a restaurant, Marina Palms, and which is located right at the club actually. So you can enjoy the dining over here or either the bar and have a cocktail and just watch the sunset from here. It is beautiful. I really like it because it's a different vibe. It's a bit more calm, a little more luxurious, and it's very private. There are not too many people over here, and you can definitely have a unique time with your partner or with your family. So it's truly a great place to come and visit. So next on our list, we're here at Pineapple Beach. This beach is really beautiful, relaxing and quiet. It's located kind of in the border of St. James and Hanover. So it's a bit of a drive outside of the town, but it's really worth it. They have a beautiful dining area over here, a great restaurant, a bar which has really affordable prices as well. And also this beach has also a big lawn area where you can come and enjoy their yoga classes that they do over here on Wednesdays. Or if you're into music, they do have live band playing here every Thursday, and on Friday and Saturday they have a party vibe over here with a live DJ playing. I love this beach because you can definitely come here and again enjoy your day, come with either a family or just a friend, and they have everything here, every amenities that you would look for, restroom, changing rooms, and lots of space. So if you're a person that's looking for a peaceful area to just relax and spend a whole afternoon, this is the location. It's definitely a place where you can get some quiet time, enjoy the beautiful weather over here, and just take the time to relax. Alright, so our next location is a real exciting and fun one. Guess where I am? Go-karting in Montego Bay. People, this is the place to come with your family and friends. It's a really cool vibe over here. They have music throughout the day. You can come here, enjoy the karting, and they have also a ball field over here. This place is located in Toca Irwin in Montego Bay. It's a bit outside of the city, but it's definitely worth the drive. It's perfect if you're coming with kids or for families. You can kart around over here. And the beauty about this place, again, it's on a budget, so it's only 600 Jamaican to participate and do the activities over here. Really beautiful place to just spend the afternoon with your family or just come over here and have fun. Our last stop of the day is Sola's restaurant on Top Road, Montego Bay. This is a beautiful location. Trust me guys, you have to come and visit over here, get a drink or dine, but it's really, really beautiful. You have to see the view. Follow me. So that's it everyone, this was the full list of activities and things you can do in Montego Bay on a budget and under 10 US. So let me know in the comments below if you've ever visited one of those places before, and also like below if you like this video and make sure that you share it with a friend, subscribe and just stay tuned because there is so much more coming.